Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And I don't know, it's not my sound system. I'll tell you what.
Okay, that's one. The welcome to Central High School and third and Oak the Laundromat, and I know you don't see it up here. The one act play is a really intriguing contest in UIL's is, in that it takes a group of young people from the beginning of a production to the end in 1 hour. Stage breakdown and group play. They have 10 minutes to set the stage. They have 40 minutes to perform, and they have 10 minutes to strike the set and get it where it belongs. Now, this is not like football. They don't throw a flag. If you run overtime, you're through. You lose. You're not considered. And so there's a great deal of pressure. There's a great deal of timing involved. And there's a number of people involved that you never see on the stage normally. And they're a very integral part of one act play because it must happen on time, it must be done right, and they're as well orchestrated as any group of athletes that we have. And we're going to tonight set it up for you and let you see it, let you see how it goes on during the normal one act play contest. All this is done behind the curtain. But tonight, we're going to show you everybody and everything that they do. Okay, kids, break your legs. Let's go.
song for tonight, Night Owl. This is your number one Night Owl saying it's 3 o'clock, all right, and time to rock your daddy to dreams of delight. Now, Mama, I'm coming home. The rest of you Night Owls are going to have to make it through the rest of this night by yourself, or with the help of your friends, if you know what I mean, and you know what I mean.
Hello? Sleep. Is that how you do your job? Sleep? What they pay you to do? Sleep? Listen, it's fine with me. Better in fact. I'm glad, actually. You want him out here talking to you? You came to do your wash, so do your wash. Now, well, first. There. Good. It's all right, nothing breakable. Cleaned up, that's all. You've been up this late before. Nothing's the matter with you, just nerves and gravity.
Good breath. Are you all right?
Cute, huh? Probably just a wet spot on the floor.
I already picked these clothes off the floor once tonight. We've been in our apartment 2 years and Joe still ain't found the closets. He thinks hangers are for when you lock your keys in the car. I mean, he's got this coat made of sheep's fur or something, and my mom came over one day and asked where'd we get that fuzzy little rug. Joe works at the Ford plant. I asked him why they call it that. I said, how often do you have to water a Ford plant? It was just a little joke, but he didn't think it was very funny.
They probably do have a sprinkler system.
I should have just saved my breath and tripped over the coffee table. He'd laughed at that. Well, I guess it's just you and me.
Yes.
Guess not too many people suds their duds in the middle of the night.
Suds their duds.
I do mine at Mom's. I mean, I take our stuff over to Mom's. She's got matching Maytags, and we sit around and watch the soaps till the clothes come out. Suds duds, that's what she says. Well, more than that, she wrote on this little card and sent it to cheer so they could use it on the TV ads.
Gives you a chance to talk, I guess. Visit.
She says, just leave them, I'll do them, but that wouldn't be right, so I stay. Of course, she never says how she likes seeing me, but she holds back and all. You know, there are things you don't have to say when it's family.
Is she out of town tonight?
No, she's probably just asleep. 3-cycle Turbomatic Deluxe. Hot wash, warm rinse. Warm wash, cold rinse, and cold wash, cold rinse. What's this? Add laundry aid.
Your mother does your laundry?
You don't have a washer either, huh?
It's broken.
Well, get your husband to fix it. He got a heap of shirts, don't he?
It can't be fixed.
Where are your clothes?
Mine are mostly hand wash.
We just dump all our stuff in together.
That's nice.
Joe can fix just about anything. He's real good with his hands. I've been saying that since high school. He makes trucks. I'd hate to see the truck I put together. He works the double shift. They do all kinds out there. Dump trucks and pickup trucks.
Well, overtime pays well, I imagine.
It's all the time here lately. He says people are buying more trucks because farmers are raising more cows because we got a population explosion going on. Really crummy, no. People I don't even know having babies means Joe can't come home at the right time. Don't seem fair.
Or true.
Huh?
Well, the population explosion is over. The birth rate is very stable now.
Oh.
Still, it's no fun to be in the house by yourself.
See, we live right over there on top of that Mexican restaurant. That window with the blue line in it, that's ours. It's a bunch of blueberries on a stalk, only it's alive. Joe gave it to me. He thinks blue is my favorite color.
So the restaurant noise was bothering you?
Well, they got this bar that stays open till 4. That's how Joe picked the apartment. He hates to run out late for beer, but he don't mind running down. Old Mexico Taco Tavern. Except Joe says it's supposed to be Olay Mexico, like what they say in bullfights.
Bullfights are disgusting.
You've seen a real bullfight?
We used to travel quite a bit.
Well, tell me about it.
There's not much to tell. The bull comes out and they kill it.
What for?
Fun. Doesn't that sound like fun to you?
So your husband works nights too?
Herb is out of town. Did you mean to put that in there?
Huh?
Your whites will come out green.
Oh, Joe wouldn't like that. No, sir, it'd be like this time when Mom's washer chewed this hole in his bowling shirt. Woo, was he hot. He kicked the chest of drawer and broke his toe. And the chest of drawers, too. Is Herb picky like that?
Herb likes to look nice.
Hey, you forgot one, see? Ooh, yuck, it looks like vomit.
It's my cabbage soup.
Well, in it goes.
No.
The other?
No, it's too. I don't want to. The steak would never. It needs to pre-soak. I forgot the wool eye.
Sorry.
That's quite all right.
Does this machine give soap? It takes dimes. I only got quarters.
The attendant will give you change.
He's asleep. Be terrible waking just for some old dimes. You got any change?
No.
Looks like he's got a pocket full of money. They could wake him up if I stuck my hand in there.
20 years ago, baby. Here, I found some. That's 10, 20, 30, 40, 50.
No, he shouldn't be sleeping like that. Somebody could come in here and rob him. You don't think he's dead or anything, do you? I mean, I probably wouldn't know if I saw somebody dead.
You'd know.
Well, cheer up. That's what my mom always said. Cheer up. Hey, my name is Dee Dee. Dee Dee Johnson.
Nice to meet you.
What's yours?
Alberta.
Alberta what?
Alberta Johnson.
Hey, we might be related. I mean, Harp and Joe could be cousins or something.
I don't think so.
Yeah, I guess there's lots of Johnsons.
Yes.
I'm bothering you, aren't I? I've talked to somebody else, but there ain't nobody else. Except Sleepy back there. I talk in my sleep. He looks like he's lucky to be breathing in his. Sleep, I mean.
Well, would you like a magazine?
No, thank you. I brought a Dr. Pepper. You can have it if you want.
No, thank you.
Sleepy was one of the seven dwarfs. I could still name them off. I couldn't take seven presidents of the United States, but I could say the dwarfs. They're Sleepy, Grumpy, Sneezy, Dopey, Doc, Bashful, and, who's the other one?
You could name seven presidents.
Oh, no.
Try it.
Okay. There's Carter, Nixon, Kennedy, Lincoln, Ben Franklin, George Washington, and,
Eleanor Roosevelt's husband.
Mr. Roosevelt.
Mr. Roosevelt. That's seven, except Benjamin Franklin was never president.
You're a teacher or something, aren't you?
I was. Say Mr. Roosevelt again.
Mr. Roosevelt.
There, Teddy makes seven.
Around here or in the county schools?
Ohio. Columbus.
Right.
Do you know Columbus?
Not personally. I better be careful.
No ain'ts or nothing. Oh, you couldn't say anything I hadn't already heard.
You want me to try?
No.
Well, what does Harp do?
Is Dee Dee short for something? Deidre? Deborah?
No, just Dee Dee. The guys always kidding me about my name in high school. Why'd you quit teaching?
Age.
You don't look old enough to retire.
Oh, not my age.
Theirs. Mine, you mean?
Actually, Mother was very sick then.
Is she still alive?
No.
I'm sorry.
Oh, it was a blessing, really. There was quite a lot of pain at the end.
For her, maybe, but what about you? Oh,
well, she was the one with the pain.
Sounds like she was lucky to have their nurse or all.
I read her Wuthering Heights 5 times that year. I kept checking different ones out of the library, you know, Little Women, Pride and Prejudice. Each time she'd say, no. I think I'd like to hear Wuthering Heights. Just like she hadn't heard it in 50 years. But each time I'd read the last page, I'd look up and she'd say just the same thing.
What thing?
She'd say, I still don't see it. Well, they didn't have to have all that trouble. All they had to do was find Heathcliff someplace to go every day. The man just needed a job. But maybe I missed something. Read it again?
My mom thinks Joe's a bum. No, really, she kept paying this guy from Walgreens to come over and strip our wallpaper. She said, Dee Dee, he's going to be manager of that drugstore someday. The only reason he worked there was getting a discount on his pimple cream. She thought that would get me off Joe. No way. We've been married 2 years last month. Mom says this is the itch here.
The itch here?
When guys get the itch, you know, staying out late, coming in with stories about going with the drink, drinking with the boys, or working overtime, or something. Is that clock right?
I think so.
But Herb never did that, huh?
Being faithful, you mean? No.
How can you be so sure like that? You keep him in the refrigerator?
Well, I suppose he could have.
Like right now, while he's up in wherever he is?
Akron.
He could be sitting in some all-night bowling alley, polishing some big blonde bowling ball.
No.
That's real nice to trust him like that.
Aren't you afraid Joe will call you on his break and be worried about where you are?
You got any kids?
No.
Didn't you want some?
Oh, yes.
Me too. Lots of them. But Joe says he has to be earning lots of money before he starts a family.
Well, that's why he works this double shift.
Well, yeah. Only now he's building up this 64 Chevy he bought to drag race. And then when the race money starts coming in, we can have them kids. He's looking real forward to that, winning a big race and having me and kids run out on the track. Him smiling and grabbing up the baby, pouring beer all over so all the crowd's screaming and yelling.
So all this money goes into this car?
Hey, I love it too. Sundays we go to the garage and work on it. See that devil painted there on the door? That costs $200.
You help him?
He says it's just a real big help having me there watching.
I never understood that. Men wanting you to watch them do whatever it was. I mean, well, every year at Thanksgiving, Herb would watch over me, washing the turkey, making the stuffing, stuffing the turkey. Made me nervous.
You could have told him to get lost, Danny.
Well, actually, the last 10 years or so, I sent him out to the stage for the dressing. He'd come in and sit down and say, boy, was this ever going to be the best turkey yet? Rub his hands together. And I'd come all worried and bump bottles around in the cabinets and say, well, Herb, I don't think I have enough sage. He'd say, well, Bertie, my girl, I'll just go to the store and get some.
I saw white pepper in the store last week. How did they do that?
I don't know.
Is Dr. Pepper made out of pepper?
I don't know.
And what did Herb do that you had to watch? I mean,
he gotched. I didn't have to watch him plant the seeds or weed the plants or spray for pepper to pick okra. When the day came to turn over the soil, that was the day. Herb would bring a rototiller and bring a lawn chair out from the garage. He'd wipe it off and call in the kitchen window, Alberta, it's so pleasant out here in the sunshine. And when he finished, he'd get this little sign out of the garage and drive it into the ground.
What did it say?
Herb garden. He thought it was funny.
Did you laugh?
Every year.
He wasn't doing one no more?
No.
Why not?
What's out there?
Oh, nothing.
Well, you just look like...
Well, Josh should be home soon. I turned out all the lights except for the bluebird so I can tell when he comes in. You know, when he turns on the lights.
Well, when is the shift over?
Oh, not for a long time yet. I just thought he might get through early and we could go bowl a few games. Of course, he might stop off and have a beer first. Typing down hourly or by the page. Cheer. What on earth?
It must be cheap. It better be cheap.
Most of this stuff's over already. Garden tools, never used. Rake, hoe, spade, and towel.
Trowel.
You got great eyes, Alberta. 459-4734. A. Johnson. Hey, you think this A. Johnson might be related to us? Oh, that's right. You said Herb wasn't doing the garden anymore. No, I got it. This A. Johnson is you, and the reason Herb isn't doing a garden anymore is because you're selling his rakes. But that says never used. Alberta, you shouldn't try to fool people like that, washing up Herb's hoe and selling it like it was new. Bad girl.
Actually, that is me. I bought Herb new garden tools for his birthday, and then he gave it up. Gardening.
Before his birthday?
What?
Well, did you have time to buy another present?
Oh, yes. Well, no. I mean, he told me before his birthday. I just didn't have a chance to get him anything else.
He's probably got everything in his house.
About.
Well, didn't he get his feelings hurt?
No.
Don't ever like the stuff I give him.
Oh, I'm sure he does. He just doesn't know how to tell you.
No, he doesn't. For our anniversary, I played real far ahead for this one. I'm telling you, I snuck my picture, well, not a whole body picture, just my face real close up to this place in Massachusetts. And they, well, I don't know if they painted it, but somehow or another, they got my face on this doll. It was unbelievable how it really looked like me. About this tall, overalls, and a checkered shirt. I thought it was real cute. And I wrote this card saying, from one living doll to another, let's keep keep playing house till the day we die.
And he didn't like it?
He laughed so hard he fell over backwards out of his chair and cracked his head open on the radiator. We had to take him to the emergency room.
I'm sorry.
Well, we were sitting there waiting for him to get sewed up, and this little girl comes in real sick and all. And see, Joe, he says to me, see, I brought this doll on. I don't know why. Anyway, Joe says to me, Diddy, that little girl is so much sicker than me. Well, let's give her this doll to make her feel better. Never taking her right on him. Joe rushes up and puts his doll in her arms.
They let her keep it?
Her mother said thank you. Real sweet, like they didn't have much money to buy the kid doll or something. It made Joe feel real good.
But it was your present to him. It was your face on the doll.
Yeah, but I figured it was his present as soon as I gave it to him. So if he wanted to give it away, that's his business. But he didn't like it, I could tell. I need to wash this window.
I gave Herb a fishing pole one year.
He fishes?
Oh, well, no, but I thought he wanted to. He got out this picture of this husky man standing practically up to his waist in water fishing. Well, I thought he left it out so I'd get the hint.
But he didn't?
Oh, it was a hint, all right. He wanted the hat.
Right.
Do you like the things Joe gives you?
I'd like it if he came home. That's what I'd like.
He'll be home soon. Well, you'll probably see those lights go on as soon as your clothes are dry.
Sure.
People just can't always be where we want them to be when we want them to be there.
Well, I don't like it.
Well, you don't have to like it. You just have to know it.
Well, wouldn't you like it if Herb was home right now?
I certainly would.
Because if they were both home where they should be, we wouldn't have to be here in this laundromat washing shirts in the middle of the night. I'm sorry. You probably don't do things like that. Well, neither do I very often, but I've had all I can take. Well, I don't care if he ever comes home. I'll just go next door and play pool. You know who plays pool next door? Cheater Stevens. Cheater Stevens, number one night out, WTIO 97.5. Saying it's 3 o'clock, all right, time to rock your daddy dreams a lot. I always listen to him. I mean, when I get to pick, I pick him. He's on late and I'm up late.
I'm sorry, that's not a station I ever...
He might even come in here, really. He comes in here sometimes. One night, I was doing my wash, and in he comes to his. How about that? He's so cute. And we went over and played pool. Well, I don't know how, but he showed me. And we were gonna go get some strawberry pancakes, but one of these nights we're gonna get those pancakes. They got this place that stays open all night down Broadway. You ever shot any pool?
No.
Of course not, I could guess that. Well, Shooter's real name is GW, and his daddy played pool with Willie in the old days. Willie owns the pool hall. Shooter's daddy killed himself. We could go off there right now. He always keeps a pot of hot water. He could have a nice cup of tea. He's about your age.
No.
I told my mom I met Shooter Stevens, but she didn't believe me. The first night he had this joke about this big fudge.
Is Shooter cake. Married too?
It just makes you sick, doesn't it?
What?
Man, another man.
It's not my business.
That's for sure. You don't listen to him on the radio, but I do. And you know what he says after he says, rock your daddy the dreams of the light? He says, and mama, I'm coming home. Now, what's he doing washing his own clothes if he's got a mama? So he don't got a mama, and that means lonely. And he's loaded too, so if he's got a wife, she's got a washer. Don't say maybe they don't got a washer.
Well, you should be careful. You could, well, you never know,
you know
what.
He does the commercials for Olay Mexico Taco Tavern. See, that's how I knew. He came in here eating one of their tacos. He said, care to join me in a taco? And then he said, Olay Mexico's very own, very hot taco sauce. Just like he says it on the radio. I was in love.
He was trying to pick you up, and it worked. We don't know who he really was. Maybe he was just somebody who listened to the radio as much as you do. You were lucky you didn't get raped. Does Joe know you went out?
He was Shooter Stevens. I'm not that dumb. I've seen his picture, and he just wanted somebody to talk to. I mean, we're both here in the middle of the night, you and me, and it don't mean we're on the make, does it?
It's perfectly respectable.
Do you always do this when Herb's out of town?
No.
You don't even live in this neighborhood, do you?
No.
You know how I knew that? That garden. There ain't a garden for miles around here.
You've been reading Sherlock Holmes.
So why'd you come over here?
I came for the same reason you did, to do my wash in the middle of the night.
Ha, it's a big mystery, isn't it? You don't want to tell me. Is some man meeting you here? Yeah, and you can't have your meeting out where you live because your friends might think you have the word to old her when he gets home.
No. Look, I'm sorry I said what I did. Go on over to the pool hall. I'll put your clothes in the dryer.
Oh, let him think I'm chasing him? No, sir. Besides, Joe might come home.
That's right.
Might just serve him right, though, to come in and see me play in the pool with Willie and Cheer. That teacher run out on me. A little dose of his own medicine. And watch him gag on it.
So he's run out on you?
He's working double shift.
That's what you said.
And you don't believe me. You think he just didn't come home, is that it? Think I was over there waiting and waiting in my new nightgown? When the late show went off, I turned on the radio and ate a whole pint of chocolate ice cream. And when the radio went off, I couldn't stand it anymore. So I grabbed up all these clothes that were here so he wouldn't come in and find me crying. Well, I wasn't crying.
I haven't cried in 40 years.
Just happy, I guess.
Happy. The other dwarf's name. The seven dwarfs, and you only said six. Happy.
Great.
I had that Dora, who had a rabbit, Puffer, who died. I cried then. I cried for weeks.
It wasn't even your rabbit.
I loved Aunt Dora. She loved that rabbit. Well, I'd go over there in the afternoon, and she'd tell me what Puffer had done that day. She claimed he told the stories. Goldilocks and the three hares. The rabbit who ate New York. We'd go outside and drink lemonade while Puffer ate lettuce. She grew lettuce just for him. A whole backyard of it.
Little cracked, huh?
I helped her bury it. Tears were streaming down my face. Bertie, she said, don't cry. He'd feel bad if he knew he made us miserable. He didn't mean to go and leave us all alone. But in the next few weeks, Aunt Dora got quieter and quieter until finally she wasn't talking at all. Mother put her in the nursing home.
Before she died?
Yes.
Hey, our wash is done. Look, I'll do it. You sit, okay?
No, I...
Don't let me whirling. I know this part. Mom says you can't blow this part, so I do it. She still finds some reason, though, to go downstairs and check the heat I set. I don't mind, really. Can't be too careful, I guess. Let's see. Regular for you guys. Warm for permos and undies. Shirts and shorts get hot. Pants and socks get washed. What's her got left to wear anyhow?
This gray suit.
What color tie?
Red. Silver stripe.
Shirt?
White.
Shoes?
I don't know.
Well, I'm glad. Thought you were seeing him all the way to Akron. X-ray eyes or something weird. Alberta?
Yes?
Got any dimes?
Sure. How many do we need?
Two each, I guess. Four dryers may say. I don't know what I'd done if you hadn't been here. I didn't think before I...
You'd have done just fine. And don't forget Sleepy back there.
I wish Mom were more like you.
Stuck up?
Smart. Nice to talk to.
Well, thank you, but...
No, really. You've been to Mexico and you've got a good man. Mom's just got me a giant-sized chair. She don't say two words while I'm there. Ever.
Well...
Yeah.
But you're young and pretty. You have a wonderful sense of humor. And you'll have those children someday.
Yeah, I know. I've got my whole life in front of me.
You could get a job.
Oh, I've got one. This company, New Jersey, they send me letters and envelopes and lists of names. And I write on the letter, Dear Mr. Wilson, or whatever. I do have nice handwriting.
I'm sure.
I get so bored doing it. Sometimes I want to take a fat orange crayon and scribble, eat beans. Fatso, they draw funny faces all over the letter.
Well, I'm sure the extra money comes in handy.
Oh, Joe don't know I do it. I hide all the stuff before he comes home. And I keep the money at Mom's. She borrows from it sometimes. Says that makes it even for the washing machine. I don't mind, really. See, I can't spend it or Joe will know I got it.
He doesn't want you to work?
I'm the head of this house.
He expects you to sit around all day?
I guess. Oh, I can wash the floor if I want.
Well, you should tell him how you feel.
He'd leave me.
Well, maybe.
So what, right?
I just meant if you give him the chance to understand.
But what would I say?
You'd think of something, I'm sure.
I don't want to start it. I don't want to say I don't want a real job. Then I'll have to say the reason I want a real job. Because I've got to have something to think about. Besides, when are you coming home? And how long is it going to be before you don't come home at all? And he'll say, what do you mean, don't come home at all? And I'll say, I know what you're doing. I know you're lying to me and cheating on me. And he'll say, what do you want to do about it? You want a divorce? And I don't want him to say that.
Now you don't know.
Oh, I called the bowling alley and asked for him. The bartender said, this taxi, he's on his way, honey. Oh, he falls in the sewer.
Dee Dee.
I hope he gets his shirt caught in his zipper. I hope his right guard gives out. I hope he wore socks with holes in them. I hope his baseball cap falls in the toilet. I hope she kills him.
Dee Dee.
I do. Last night I bought a surprise and it made me bowl a few games. Well, I was up there getting my shoes and I saw him down at lane 12 laughing and all. He had one hand rubbing her hair and the other one rubbing his bowling ball. Boy, did I get out of there quick. I've seen her there before. She teaches at that weight control upstairs. So she's probably not very strong. But maybe she could poison him. I hate him.
I'm sure you don't really.
He's mean and stupid. I thought he'd get over it. Mean and stupid. And I ain't all that smart, so if I know he's dumb, he must really be dumb. I used to think he just acted mean and stupid. Now I know he really is.
Mean and stupid.
Why am I telling you this? You don't know nothing about being dumb.
Well, at least you have some money saved.
For what?
And your mother would let you stay with her until you got a place of your own.
She's the last person I'm telling.
I'll bet you'd like her being a telephone operator.
But how's he gonna eat? The only time he ever fried an egg, he flipped it over and it landed in the sink. And it was the last egg, so he grabbed it up and ate it in one bite.
One bite?
I like the way he comes in the door. He picks me up and swings me around.
He stuffed a whole egg in his mouth.
You're worse than Mom. Look, he's going to be a famous race car driver someday, and I want
to
be there.
To have him pour beer all over you?
Yes, to have him pour beer all over me.
You could have come in without turning on the lights. If you want to go check, I'll watch your things.
You want to get rid of me, don't you?
I do not want to get rid of you.
So why don't you go home? Go get the wool out of that yucky shirt you didn't wash. You not only didn't want me to touch that shirt, you don't even want to talk to me.
I didn't want to wash it.
That ain't it at all. Herb is so wonderful. You love him so much. I could never drop a shirt and wash it the way you do it. The stain might not come out, and he might ask, what did you do to my shirt? And you might fight. That would mess up your little dream where everything's always sweet and you just go around gardening and giving each other little pecky kisses all the time. Well, you're either kidding yourself or lying to me. Nobody's so wonderful somebody else can't touch their shirt. You act like he's a saint, like he's dead and now you worship the shirt. And what do I have to do to get you to leave me alone? He is, Danny.
Yes.
I'm so stupid.
You.
What? Tell me. Say something horrible.
You just don't know when to shut up.
Worse than that, I don't know how.
But you're not dumb, child. Don't let anyone ever tell you you are, okay?
I'm so sorry, Miss Johnson. You've probably been planning this night for a long time, and I've barged in and spoiled it all.
I've been avoiding it for a long time. Herb died last winter, the day before his birthday.
Did you go off the rails?
He was being nosy, like I told you before, in the kitchen. I was baking his cake, so I asked him to take out the garbage. He said, can't we wait till it's old enough to walk?
No.
I didn't miss him until I put his cake in the oven. Guess I thought he was checking his seed beds in the garage. So I yelled out, Herb, do you want buttercream or chocolate? Then I saw him. lying in the alley, covered in my cabbage soup. It was his heart. Well, did you call the... I picked up his head in my hand and tried to clean up as much of the stuff as I could. Tuna can, toffee crumbs, eggshells. You know, he was dead, not just knocked out. He'd hit his head when he fell.
Oh, my God.
He was bleeding in my hand. I knew I should get up, but the blood was still so warm.
I'm so sorry.
I don't want you to be alone. That's not what I meant before.
Looks like I'm alone anyway.
That's what I meant.
Sometimes I bring a little stand-up mirror, put it on the edge of the coffee table while I'm watching TV. It's my face over there when I look, but it's a face just the same.
Being alone isn't so awful. I mean, it's awful, but it's not that awful. There are hard things.
I've tried pork and beans for weeks.
I found our beach ball when I cleaned out the basement. And I can't let the air out of it. It's his breath in there. Get your clothes out, they're wrinkled. You know, it's amazing about the shoes.
The shoes?
Well, remember I told you what Herb had on? A gray suit,
white shirt, red tie with a silver stripe through it.
I hang on to the shirt he died in, and I don't even know if he has shoes on in his coffin.
Well, if he's flying around heaven, he probably don't need them. He bought them all black socks.
That was his idea. He thought they'd be easier to match if they were all the same color.
Is it?
No. They may all be black, but they don't all shrink the same. I guess I don't have to match them now, though, do I?
I'd like to lose all Joe's white ones.
Dee Dee, your lights are on. In your apartment, all your lights are on now.
Yeah. So what should I do?
I don't know.
Should I rush right home? Ask Joe, did he have a good time bowling a few games after his double shift? Listen to him brag about his score. His score he didn't make in the games he didn't bowl after the double shift he didn't work. Well, I don't feel like it. I'm gonna go next door and play some pool. I'll make him miss me.
You should go home before you forget how mad you are. You don't have to put up with what he's doing. You can if you want to, if you think you can't make it without him. But you don't have to.
But what do I say? Joe, if you don't stop going at me, I'm not ever speaking to you again. That's exactly what he wants.
What you say isn't important. But there's something you need to remember while you say it.
Which is?
Your own face in a mirror is better company than a man who would eat a whole fried egg in one bite. But it won't be easy.
Are you gonna wash that other shirt ever?
The cabbage soup shirt? No, I don't think so.
Yeah.
Maybe next year or in a few months, I'll be able to give these things away. They're nice things.
People do need them. Hey, you better hold on to these. I told you there ain't a garden for miles around here. It's getting about time to turn over the soil again, isn't it?
In another 2 weeks. Well, yes, it is. Well, that's everything. I'll just get my soap and be going.
Miss Johnson?
Alberta.
Alberta?
Yes?
I'm really lonely.
I know.
How can you stand it?
I can't. But I have to, just the same.
Well, how do I? How do you do that?
I don't know. You call me if you think of something.
I'll have your number.
You know, I really wanted to be alone tonight.
I know.
I'm glad you talked me out of it.
Boy, you can count on me for that. Hey, don't go yet. I owe you some money.
No. Everyone deserves a free load every now and then.
Thank you.
Now, I suggest you go wake up Sleepy back there and see if there's something he needs to talk about.
Tell you the truth, I'm ready for a little peace and quiet.
Good night.
Yeah, peace and quiet. Too bad it don't come in cans.
all for tonight, Night Owls. This is your number one, Night Owl, saying it's 3 o'clock, all right, and time to rock your daddy to dreams of delight. Now, Mama, I'm coming home. The rest of you Night Owls are going to have to make it through the rest of this night by yourself, or with the help of your friends, if you know what I mean, and you know what I mean.
Hello? Sleep. Is that how you do your job? Sleep? What they pay you to do? Sleep? Listen, it's fine with me. Better than that. I'm glad, actually. You want him out here talking to you? You came to do your wash, so do your wash. Now, well, first. There. Good. It's all right, nothing breakable. Cleaned up, that's all. You've been up this late before. Nothing's the matter with you, just nerves and gravity. Ooh, are you all right?
Cute, huh?
Probably just a wet spot on the floor.
I already picked these clothes off the floor once tonight. We've been in our apartment 2 years and Joe still ain't found the closets. He thinks hangers are for when you lock your keys in the car. I mean, he's got this coat made of sheets fur or something, and my mom came over one day and asked where'd we get that fuzzy little rug. Joe works at the Ford plant. I asked him why they call it that. I said, how often do you have to water a Ford plant? It was just a little joke, but he didn't think it was very funny.
They probably do have a sprinkler system.
I should have just saved my breath and tripped over the coffee table. He'd laughed at that. Well, I guess it's just you and me.
Yes.
Guess not too many people suds their duds in the middle of the night.
Suds their duds?
I do mine at Mom's. I mean, I take our stuff over to Mom's. She's got matching Maytags, and we sit around and watch the soaps till the clothes come out. Suds duds, that's what she says. Well, more than that, she wrote on this little card and sent it to cheer so they could use it on the TV ad.
Gives you a chance to talk, I guess. Visit.
She says, just leave them, I'll do them, but that wouldn't be right, so I stay. Of course, she never says how she likes seeing me, but she holds back and all. You know, there are things you don't have to say when it's family.
Is she out of town tonight?
No, she's probably just asleep. 3-cycle Turbomatic Deluxe. Hot wash, warm rinse. Warm wash, cold rinse, and cold wash, cold rinse. What's this? Ad laundry aid.
Your mother does your laundry?
You don't have a washer either, huh?
It's broken.
Well, get your husband to fix it. He got a heap of shirts, don't he?
It can't be fixed.
Where are your clothes?
Mine are mostly hand wash.
We just dump all our stuff in together.
That's nice.
Joe can fix just about anything. He's real good with his hands. I've been saying that since high school. He makes trucks. I hate to see the truck I put together. He works the double shift. They do all kinds out there. Dump trucks and pickup trucks.
Well, overtime pays well, I imagine.
It's all the time here lately. He says people are buying more trucks because farmers are raising more cows because we got a population explosion going on. Really crummy, no. People I don't even know having babies means Joe can't come home at the right time. Don't seem fair.
Or true.
Huh?
Well, the population explosion is over. The birth rate is very stable now.
Oh.
Still, it's no fun to be in the house by yourself.
See, we live right over there on top of that Mexican restaurant. That window with the blue line in it, that's ours. It's a bunch of blueberries on a stalk, only it's alive. Joe gave it to me. He thinks blue is my favorite color.
So the restaurant noise was bothering you?
Well, they got this bar that stays open till 4. That's how Joe picked the apartment. He hates to run out late for beer, but he don't mind running down. Old Mexico Taco Tavern. Except Joe says it's supposed to be Olay Mexico, like what they say in bullfights.
Bullfights are disgusting.
You've seen a real bullfight?
We used to travel quite a bit.
Well, tell me about it.
There's not much to tell. The bull comes out and they kill it.
What for?
Fun. Doesn't that sound like fun to you?
So your husband works nights too?
Well, Herb is out of town. Did you mean to put that in there?
Huh?
Your whites will come out green.
Oh, Joe wouldn't like that. No, sir, it'd be like this time when Mom's washer chewed this hole in his bowling shirt. Woo, was he hot. He kicked the chest of drawer and broke his toe. And the chest of drawers, too. Is Herb picky like that?
Herb likes to look nice.
Hey, you forgot one, see? Ooh, yuck, it looks like vomit.
It's my cabbage soup.
Well, in it goes.
No.
The other?
No, it's too. I don't want to. The steak would never. It needs to pre-soak. I forgot the wool line.
Sorry.
That's quite all right.
Does this machine give soap? It takes dimes. I only got quarters.
The attendant will give you change.
He's asleep. Be terrible waking just for some old dimes. You got any change?
No.
Looks like he's got a pocket full of money. They could wake him up if I stuck my hand in there.
20 years ago, baby. Here, I found some. That's 10, 20, 30, 40, 50.
No, he shouldn't be sleeping like that. Somebody could come in here and rob him. You don't think he's dead or anything, do you? I mean, I probably wouldn't know if I saw somebody dead.
Cute, though.
Well, cheer up. That's what my mom always said. Cheer up. Hey, my name is Dee Dee. Dee Dee Johnson.
Nice to meet you.
What's yours?
Alberta.
Alberta what?
Alberta Johnson.
Hey, we might be related. I mean, Harp and Joe could be cousins or something.
I don't think so.
Yeah, I guess there's lots of Johnsons.
Yes.
I'm bothering you, aren't I? I talked to somebody else, but there ain't nobody else. Except Sleepy back there. I talk in my sleep. Him, he looks like he's lucky to be breathing in his. Sleep, I mean.
Well, would you like a magazine?
No, thank you. I brought a Dr. Pepper. You can have it if you want.
No, thank you.
Sleepy was one of the seven dwarfs. I could still name them off. I couldn't take seven presidents of the United States, but I could say the dwarfs. They're Sleepy, Grumpy, Sneezy, Dopey, Doc, Bashful, and, who's the other one?
You could name seven presidents.
Oh, no.
Try it.
Okay. There's Carter, Nixon, Kennedy, Lincoln, Ben Franklin, George Washington, and,
Eleanor Roosevelt's husband.
Mr. Roosevelt.
Mr. Roosevelt's husband. That's seven, except Benjamin Franklin was never president.
You're a teacher or something, aren't you?
I was. Say Mr. Roosevelt again.
Mr. Roosevelt.
There, Teddy makes seven.
Around here or in the county schools?
Ohio. Columbus.
Right.
Do you know Columbus?
Not personally. I better be careful. No ants or nothing.
Oh, you couldn't say anything I hadn't already heard.
You want me to try?
No.
Well, what does Harp do?
Is Dee Dee short for something? Deidre? Deborah?
No, just Dee Dee. The guys always kidded me about my name in high school. Why'd you quit teaching?
Age.
You don't look old enough to retire.
Oh, not my age.
Theirs. Mine, you mean?
Actually, Mother was very sick then.
Is she still alive?
No.
I'm sorry.
Oh, it was a blessing, really. There was quite a lot of pain at the end.
For her, maybe, but what about you?
Oh, well, she was the one with the pain.
Sounds like she was lucky to have you there nursing her and all.
I read her Wuthering Heights 5 times that year. I kept checking different ones out of the library, you know, Little Women, Pride and Prejudice. But each time she'd say, no, I think I'd like to hear Wuthering Heights. Just like she hadn't heard it in 50 years. But each time I'd read the last page, I'd look up and she'd say just the same thing.
What thing?
She'd say, I still don't see it. Well, they didn't have to have all that trouble. All they had to do was find Heathcliff someplace to go every day. The man just needed a job. But maybe I missed something. Read it again?
My mom thinks Joe's a bum. No, really, she kept paying this guy from Walgreens to come over and strip our wallpaper. She said, Dee Dee, he's going to be manager of that drugstore someday. The only reason he worked there was getting a discount on his pimple cream. She thought that would get me off Joe. No way. We've been married 2 years last month. Mom says this is the itch year.
The itch year?
When guys get the itch, you know, staying out late, coming in with stories about going with the drink, drinking with the boys, or working overtime or something. Is that clock right?
I think so.
But Herb never did that, huh?
Be unfaithful, you mean? No.
How can you be so sure like that? You keep him in the refrigerator?
Well, I suppose he could have.
Like right now, while he's up in wherever he is?
Akron.
He could be sitting in some all-night bowling alley, polishing some big blonde bowling ball.
No.
That's real nice to trust him like that.
Aren't you afraid Joe will call you on his break and be worried about where you are?
You got any kids?
No.
Didn't you want some?
Oh, yes.
Me too. Lots of them. But Joe says he has to be earning lots of money before he starts a family.
Well, that's why he works this double shift.
Well, yeah. Only now he's building up this 64 Chevy he bought to drag race. And then when the race money starts coming in, we can have them kids. He's looking real forward to that, winning a big race and having me and the kids run out on the track. Him smiling and grabbing up the baby, pouring beer all over so all the crowd's screaming and yelling.
So all this money goes into this car?
Hey, I love it too. Sundays we go to the garage and work on it. See that devil painted there on the door? That costs $200.
You help him?
He says it's just a real big help having me there watching.
I never understood that. Men wanting you to watch them do whatever it was. I mean, well, every year at Thanksgiving, Herb would watch over me, washing the turkey, making the stuffing, stuffing the turkey. Made me nervous.
You could have told him to get lost, Danny.
Well, actually, the last 10 years or so, I sent him out to save for the dressing. He'd come in and sit down and say, boy, was this ever going to be the best turkey yet? Rub his hands together. And I'd get all worried and bump bottles around in the cabinets and say, well, Herb, I don't think I have enough sage. He'd say, well, Bertie, my girl, I'll just go to the store and get some.
I saw white pepper in the store last week. How did they do that?
I don't know.
Is Dr. Pepper made out of pepper?
I don't know.
And what did Herb do that you had to watch, I mean?
He gardened. I didn't have to watch him plant the seeds or weed the plants or spray for pepper to pick okra. When the day came to turn over the soil, that was the day. Herb would run a rototiller and bring a lawn chair out from the garage. He'd wipe it off and call in the kitchen window, Alberta, it's so pleasant out here in the sunshine. And when he finished, he'd get this little sign out of the garage and drive it into the ground.
What did it say?
Herb garden. He thought it was funny.
Did you laugh?
Every year.
He didn't want to do one no more?
No.
Why not?
What's out there?
Oh, nothing.
Well, you just look like...
Well, Josh should be home soon. I turned out all the lights except for the blueberry so I can tell when he comes in. You know, when he turns on the lights.
Well, when is the shift over?
Oh, not for a long time yet. I just thought he might get through early and we could go bowl a few games. Of course, he might stop off and have a beer first. Typing down hourly or by the page. Cheer. What on earth?
It must be cheap. It better be cheap.
Most of this stuff's over already. Garden tools, never used. Rake, hoe, spade, and towel.
Trout.
You got great eyes, Alberta. 459-4734. A. Johnson. Hey, you think this A. Johnson might be related to us? Oh, that's right. You said Herb wasn't doing the garden anymore. No, I got it. This A. Johnson is you, and the reason Herb isn't doing a garden anymore is because you're selling his rakes. But that says never used. Alberta, you shouldn't try to fool people like that, washing up Herb's hoe and selling it like it was new. Bad girl.
Actually, that is me. I bought Herb new garden tools for his birthday, and then he gave it up. Gardening.
Before his birthday?
What?
Well, did you have time to buy another present?
Oh, yes. Well, no. I mean, he told me before his birthday. I just didn't have a chance to get him anything else.
He's probably got everything in his house just about. Well, didn't he get his feelings hurt?
No.
Don't ever like the stuff I give him.
Oh, I'm sure he does. He just doesn't know how to tell you.
No, he doesn't. For our anniversary, I planned real far ahead for this one. I'm telling you, I snuck my picture. Well, not a whole body picture, just my face real close up to this place in Massachusetts. And they, well, I don't know if they painted it, but somehow or another, they got my face on this doll. It was unbelievable how it really looked like me. about this tall, overalls, and that checkered shirt. I thought it was real cute, and I wrote this card saying, from one living doll to another, let's keep playing house till the day we die.
And he didn't like it?
He laughed so hard he fell over backwards out of his chair and cracked his head open on the radiator. We had to take him to the emergency room.
I'm sorry.
Well, we were sitting there waiting for him to get sewed up, and this little girl comes in real sick and all. And see, Joe, he says to me, see, I brought this doll on, I don't know why. Anyway, Joe says to me, Diddy, that little girl is so much sicker than me. Well, let's give her this doll and make her feel better. Never taking her right on him. Joe rushes up and puts his doll in her arms.
They let her keep it?
Her mother said thank you, real sweet, like they didn't have much money to buy the kid doll or something. It made Joe feel real good.
But it was your present to him. It was your face on the doll.
Yeah, but I figure it was his present as soon as I gave it to him. So if he wanted to give it away, that's his business. But he didn't like it, I could tell. I need to wash this window.
I gave Herb a fishing pole one year.
He fishes?
Oh, well, no, but I thought he wanted to. He got out this picture of this husky man standing practically up to his waist in water fishing. Well, I thought he left it out so I'd get the hint.
But he didn't?
Oh, it was a hint, all right. He wanted the hat.
Right.
Do you like the things Joe gives you?
I'd like it if he came home. That's what I'd like.
He'll be home soon. Well, you'll probably see those lights go on as soon as your clothes are dry.
Sure.
People just can't always be where we want them to be when we want them to be there.
Well, I don't like it.
Well, you don't have to like it. You just have to know it.
Well, wouldn't you like it if Herb was home right now?
I certainly would.
Because if they were both home where they should be, we wouldn't have to be here in this laundromat washing shirts in the middle of the night. I'm sorry, you probably don't do things like that. Well, neither do I very often, but I've had all I can take. Well, I don't care if he ever comes home. I'll just go next door and play pool. You know who plays pool next door? Cheater Stevens. Cheater Stevens, number one night out, WTIO 97.5. Saying it's 3 o'clock, all right, time to rock your daddy dreams a lot. I always listen to him. I mean, when I get to pick, I pick him. He's on late and I'm up late.
I'm sorry, that's not a station I ever...
He might even come in here, really. He comes in here sometimes. One night, I was doing my wash, and in he comes with his. How about that? He's so cute. And we went over and played pool. Well, I don't know how, but he showed me. And we were going to go get some strawberry pancakes, but one of these nights, we're going to get those pancakes. They got this place that stays open all night down Broadway. You ever shot any pool?
No.
Of course not. I could have guessed that. Well, Shooter's real name is G.W., and his daddy played pool with Willie in the old days. Willie owns a pool hall. Shooter's daddy killed himself. We can go off there right now. He always keeps a pot of hot water. You could have a nice cup of tea. He's about your age.
No.
I told my mom I met Shooter Stevens, but she didn't believe me. The first night he had this joke about this big fudge.
Is Shooter married too?
It just makes you sick, doesn't it?
What?
Man, another man.
It's not my business.
That's for sure. You don't listen to him on the radio, but I do. And you know what he says after he says, rock your daddy to dreams of the light? He says, and mama, I'm coming home. Now, what's he doing washing his own clothes if he's got a mama? So he don't got a mama, and that means lonely. And he's loaded too, so if he's got a wife, she's got a washer. Don't say maybe they don't got a washer.
But you should be careful. You could, well, you never know,
you know
what.
He does the commercials for Olay Mexico Taco Tavern. See, that's how I knew him. He came in here eating one of their tacos. He said, care to join me in a taco? And then he said, Olay Mexico's very own, very hot taco sauce. Just like he says it on the radio. I was in love.
He was trying to pick you up, and it worked. We don't know who he really was. Maybe he was just somebody who listened to the radio as much as you do. You were lucky you didn't get raped. Does Joe know you went out?
He was Shooter Stevens. I'm not that dumb. I've seen his picture, and he just wanted somebody to talk to. I mean, we're both here in the middle of the night, you and me, and it don't mean we're on the make. does it?
It's perfectly respectable.
Do you always do this when Herb's out of town?
No.
You don't even live in this neighborhood, do you?
No.
You know how I knew that? That garden. There ain't a garden for miles around here.
You've been reading Sherlock Holmes.
So why'd you come over here?
I came for the same reason you did, to do my wash.
In the middle of the night? Ha! It's a big mystery, isn't it? You don't want to tell me. Is some man meeting you here? Yeah, and you can't have your meeting out where you live because your friends might think you have the word to old Herb when he gets home.
No. Look, I'm sorry I said what I did. Go on over to the pool hall. I'll put your clothes in the dryer.
Oh, let him think I'm chasing him? No, sir. Besides, Joe might come home.
That's right.
Might just serve him right, though, to come in and see me play in the pool with Willie and Cheer. That teacher'd run out on me, a little dose of his own medicine, and watch him gag on it.
So he's run out on you?
He's working double shift.
That's what you said.
And you don't believe me. You think he just didn't come home, is that it? Think I was over there waiting and waiting in my new nightgown? When the light show went off, I turned on the radio and ate a whole pint of chocolate ice cream. And when the radio went off, I couldn't stand it anymore. So I grabbed up all these clothes that were here and on so he wouldn't come in and find me crying. Well, I wasn't crying.
I haven't cried in 40 years.
Just happy, I guess.
Happy. The other dwarf's name. The seven dwarfs, and you only said six. Happy.
Great.
I had that Dora, who had a rabbit, Puffer, who died. I cried then. I cried for weeks.
It wasn't even your rabbit.
I loved Aunt Dora. She loved that rabbit. Well, I'd go over there in the afternoon, and she'd tell me what Puffer had done that day. She claimed he told the stories. Goldilocks and the three hares. The rabbit who ate New York. We'd go outside and drink lemonade while Puffer ate lettuce. She grew lettuce just for him, a whole backyard of it.
Little cracked, huh?
I helped her bury it. Tears were streaming down my face. Bertie, she said, don't cry. Oh, he'd feel bad if he knew he made us miserable. He didn't mean to go and leave us all alone. But in the next few weeks, Aunt Dora got quieter and quieter until finally she wasn't talking at all. Mother put her in the nursing home.
Before she died?
Yes.
Hey, our wash is done. Look, I'll do it. You sit, okay?
No, I...
Not let me whirling. I know this part. Mom says you can't blow this part, so I do it. She still finds some reason, though, to go downstairs and check the heat I set. I don't mind, really. Can't be too careful, I guess. Let's see. Regular for you guys. Warm for permos and undies. Shirts and shorts get hot. Pants and socks get washed. What's her got left to wear anyhow?
His gray suit.
What color tie?
Red. Silver stripe.
Shirt?
White.
Shoes?
I don't know.
Well, I'm glad. Thought you were seeing him all the way to Akron. X-ray eyes or something weird. Alberta?
Yes?
Got any dimes?
Sure. How many do we need?
Two each, I guess. Four dryers may say. I don't know what I'd done if you hadn't been here. I didn't think before I...
You'd have done just fine. And don't forget Sleepy back there.
I wish Mom were more like you.
Stuck up?
Smart, nice to talk to.
Well, thank you, but...
No, really, you've been to Mexico and you've got a good man. Mom's just got me a giant-sized chair. She don't say two words while I'm there, ever.
Well,
yeah.
But you're young and pretty. You have a wonderful sense of humor.
Uh-huh.
And you'll have those children someday.
Yeah, I know. I've got my whole life in front of me.
You could get a job.
Oh, I've got one. This company, New Jersey, they send me letters and envelopes and list of names. And I write on the letter, Dear Mr. Wilson, or whatever. I do have nice handwriting.
I'm sure.
I get so bored doing it. Sometimes I want to take a fat orange granite and scribble, eat beans, fat so. They draw funny faces all over the letter.
Well, I'm sure the extra money comes in handy.
Oh, Joe don't know I do it. I hide all the stuff before he comes home. And I keep the money at Mom's. She borrows from it sometimes. Says that makes it even for the washing machine. I don't mind, really. See, I can't spend it or Joel know I got it.
He doesn't want you to work.
I'm the head of this house.
He expects you to sit around all day?
I guess. Oh, I can wash the floor if I want.
Well, you should tell him how you feel.
He'd leave me.
Well, maybe.
So what, right?
I just meant if you give him the chance to understand.
But what would I say?
You'd think of something, I'm sure.
I don't want to start it. I don't want to say I don't want a real job. Then I'll have to say the reason I want a real job. Because I've got to have something to think about. Besides, when are you coming home? And how long is it going to be before you don't come home at all? And he'll say, what do you mean, don't come home at all? And I'll say, I know what you're doing. I know you're lying to me and cheating on me. And he'll say, what do you want to do about it? You want a divorce? And I don't want him to say that.
And now you don't know.
Oh, I called the bowling alley and asked for him. The bartender said, this taxi, he's on his way, honey. Oh, he falls in the sewer.
Dee Dee.
I hope he gets his shirt caught in his zipper. I hope his right guard gives out. I hope he wore socks with holes in them. I hope his baseball cap falls in the toilet. I hope she kills him.
Dee Dee.
I do. Last night I bought a surprise and made me bowl a few games. Well, I was up there getting my shoes, and I saw him down at lane 12 laughing it off. He had one hand rubbing her hair and the other one rubbing his bowling ball. Boy, did I get out of there quick. I've seen her there before. She teaches at that weight control upstairs. So she's probably not very strong. But maybe she could poison him. I hate him.
I'm sure you don't really.
He's mean and stupid. I thought he'd get over it. Mean and stupid. And I ain't all that smart, so if I know he's dumb, he must really be dumb. I used to think he just acted mean and stupid. Now I know he really is.
Mean and stupid.
Why am I telling you this? You don't know nothing about being dumb.
Well, at least you have some money saved.
For what?
And your mother would let you stay with her until you got a place of your own.
She's the last person I'm telling.
I'll bet you'd like being a telephone operator.
But how's he gonna eat? The only time he ever fried an egg, he flipped it over and it landed in the sink. And it was the last egg, so he grabbed it up and ate it in one bite.
One bite.
I like the way he comes in the door. He picks me up and swings me around.
He stuffed a whole egg in his mouth.
You're worse than Mom. Look, he's going to be a famous race car driver someday, and I want
to
be there.
To have him pour beer all over you?
Yes, to have him pour beer all over me.
You could have come in without turning on the lights. If you want to go check, I'll watch your things.
You want to get rid of me, don't you?
I do not want to get rid of you.
So why don't you go home? Go get the wool out of that yucky shirt you didn't wash. You not only didn't want me to touch that shirt, you don't even want to talk to me.
I didn't want to wash it.
That ain't it at all. Herb is so wonderful. You love him so much. I could never drop a shirt and wash it the way you do it. The stain might not come out. And he might ask, what did you do to my shirt? And you might fight. And that would mess up your little dream where everything's always sweet and you just go around gardening and giving each other little pecky kisses all the time. Well, you're either kidding yourself or lying to me. Nobody's so wonderful somebody else can't touch their shirt. You act like he's a saint. Like he's dead and now you worship the shirt.
What do I have to do to get you to leave me alone?
He is dead.
Yes.
I'm so stupid.
You.
What? Tell me. Say something horrible.
You just don't know when to shut up.
Worse than that, I don't know how.
But you're not dumb, child. Don't let anyone ever tell you you are, okay?
I'm so sorry, Miss Johnson. You've probably been planning this night for a long time and I've barged in and spoiled it all.
I've been avoiding it for a long time. Herb died last winter, the day before his birthday.
Did you go off the rake?
He was being nosy, like I told you before, in the kitchen. I was baking his cake, so I asked him to take out the garbage. He said, can't we wait till it's old enough to walk?
No.
I didn't miss him until I put his cake in the oven. Guess I thought he was checking his seed beds in the garage. So I yelled out, Herb, do you want buttercream or chocolate? Then I saw him lying in the alley, covered in my cabbage soup. It was his heart. Well, did you call the... I picked up his head in my hand and tried to clean up as much of the stuff as I could. Tuna can, coffee grounds, eggshells. You know he was dead, not just knocked out. He'd hit his head when he fell. He was bleeding in my hand. I knew I should get up, but the blood was still so warm.
I'm so sorry.
I don't want you to be alone. That's not what I meant before.
Looks like I'm alone anyway.
That's what I meant.
Sometimes I bring a little stand-up mirror, put it on the edge of the coffee table while I'm watching TV. It's my face over there when I look, but it's a face just the same.
Being alone, Eddie, isn't so awful. I mean, it's awful, but it's not that awful. There are hard things.
I've tried pork and beans for weeks.
I found our beach ball when I cleaned out the basement. And I can't let the air out of it. It's his breath in there. Get your clothes out, they're wrinkled. You know, it's amazing about the shoes.
The shoes?
Remember I told you what Herb had on? A gray suit,
white shirt, red tie with a silver strap through it?
I hang on to the shirt he died in, and I don't even know if he has shoes on in his coffin.
Well, if he's flying around heaven, he probably don't need them. He bought them all black socks.
That was his idea. He thought they'd be easier to match if they were all the same color.
Is it?
No. They may all be black, but they don't all shrink the same. I guess I don't have to match them now, though, do I?
I'd like to lose all Joe's white ones.
Dee Dee, your lights are on. In your apartment, all your lights are on now.
Yeah. So what should I do?
I don't know.
Should I rush right home? Ask Joe, did he have a good time bowling a few games after his double shift? Listen to him brag about his score. His score he didn't make in the games he didn't bowl after the double shift he didn't work. Well, I don't feel like it. I'm gonna go next door and play some pool. I'll make him miss me.
You should go home before you forget how mad you are. You don't have to put up with what he's doing. You can if you want to, if you think you can't make it without him. But you don't have to.
But what do I say? Joe, if you don't stop going at me, I'm not ever speaking to you again. That's exactly what he wants.
What you say isn't important. But there's something you need to remember while you say it.
Which is?
Your own face in a mirror is better company than a man who would eat a whole fried egg in one bite. But it won't be easy.
Are you going to wash that other shirt ever?
The cabbage soup shirt? No, I don't think so.
Yeah.
Maybe next year or in a few months, I'll be able to give these things away. They're nice things.
People do need them. Hey, you better hold on to these. I told you there ain't a garden for miles around here. It's getting about time to turn over the soil again, isn't it?
In another 2 weeks. Well, yes, it is. Well, that's everything. I'll just get my soap and be going.
Miss Johnson?
Alberta.
Alberta?
Yes?
I'm really lonely.
I know.
How can you stand it?
I can't. But I have to, just the same.
Well, how do you do that?
I don't know. You call me if you think of something.
I'll have your number.
You know, I really wanted to be alone tonight.
I know.
I'm glad you talked me out of it.
Boy, you can count on me for that. Hey, don't go yet. I owe you some money.
No, everyone deserves a free load every now and then.
Thank you.
Now, I suggest you go wake up Sleepy back there and see if there's something he needs to talk about.
Tell you the truth, I'm ready for a little peace and quiet.
Good night.
Yeah, peace and quiet.
too bad it don't come in cans.